What up, Long Beach? Welcome back to GazetteSports.com. It's Tyler, and this boys' basketball highlight is brought to you by Naples Rib Company. Continuing on in the Torrey Pines Holiday Classic, we're at Carlsbad for a matchup between Long Beach Jordan and Long Beach St. Anthony. And I don't have to tell you, there ain't no party like a Long Beach party. Great to see these two teams getting a chance to match up in this tournament. Jordan coming into this game needing a win. Got Khalil Ferguson, who's been dealing with some injuries, but he's getting back to being fresh at that guard spot. And St. Anthony trying to make some noise and prove that they're one of the better teams in Long Beach under first-year head coach Eric Cooper. On the other side, Joel Roseborough has led a consistent Jordan program, like I said, really in need of a W and kind of been struggling through their injuries. Ferguson, though, getting things started the right way for the Panthers, getting that steal and the lay-in. But the Saints would respond. J.J. Spear with the jumper. And Justin Frazier knocks down that triple. He had five in the first quarter trying to hang with Fergie Ferg. But Rashid Johnson would answer with six of his own points in that first quarter, slashing, shooting, showing off some of his athleticism and ability to hang and finish. And then Ferguson made three of his first four shots, including that tray right there. And the Panthers have a seven-point lead after the first 8 minutes. The Saints, though, would rebound well, using that superior size and doing their best Jordan impression as Alex Nails puts that layup in transition to get the game within two. But oh, those pesky Panthers. Off the O board, Andre Springer knocks down the jumper. That would start an 11-3 Jordan run. A pair of floaters right here from Ferguson. And then Sheed knocks that down. And then dropping his football number, Rashid Johnson's going to nail that three. He had 11 points going into the half. And Jordan was up by 10 at the break. St. Anthony needing to come back and respond, they would. Dajay Green with the jumper right there. He had a team-high seven. Good defense from the Saints, getting this run out to Nails. Part of a 6-0 run to start the half, pulling within four, 27-23. Clamping down in their zone. There were no Jordan field goals in that third quarter, just 3 points overall. Alton Lister had 11 rebounds and four blocks on the game, showing off that length. Forcing some turnovers were the Saints, and this Jonathan Ross block emphatically ends the third, but still down seven were St. Anthony because they couldn't quite score enough. Jordan would start in the fourth, Andre Springer with that three, and it would spark a 15-0 run to begin the final frame as Jordan just started to run and look like the team they're supposed to be, getting those turnovers with that patented press and getting some easy breakaway layups. Johnson right here is going to serve it up to Ferguson. Rashid had 11. Khalil with 14 points, 4 boards, 2 assists, 2 steals. Andre Springer added 9 points as those guards played well for the Panthers down the stretch. Lister would break the scoring drought with that jump shot. And good to see Cypress transfer Greg Karapoulios, who has just been cleared his first game back, and his shooting touch will help St. Anthony this year. But this was Jordan's game to take. 45-30, the final score. Score one for the North Side, score one for the Moore League. And for St. Anthony, is it 2013 yet? They can't wait to get those transfers in on offense. This video brought to you in part by McCarty's Jewelry, here for you since 1932. Love to have the opportunity to cover a couple Long Beach teams playing each other in the preseason. Moore League schedule will be kicking back up very soon. The Panthers can't wait to get at those Jackrabbits. And for St. Anthony, once they get those transfers back, got a couple of marquee games against Price and Westchester at home. You can expect coverage of all of that right here at GazetteSports.com.